This was an idea that we, myself, Kenny Mann, and Tony Carlstone came up together with. Tony was used to be living in Kenya, and Kenny was born in Kenya. So when I shared this idea with them, and we all decided to come together and try to form Acacia Moyo, to be able to see how we can be able to elevate the life of people back in my area. And so far we've managed to support the four girls to go to the high school, and these are girls that we've rescued from early marriages and female genital mutilation. Now try to empower women through looking for market for their items that they've been making.
We have a group of 24 women in our community under Acacia Moyo. We need to support these ladies. We Maasai women have no an opportunity to air our problems. We have no a say in our community. One of the main things that we're trying to do is women empowerment. Because if I know my rights, nobody can mistreat me. If I know my rights, I will go to wherever I want. Educated girl is educated community.
One of the challenges we have is that many people are selling land to be able to take their kids to school. And that's one of the challenges, because many people are selling land and some children now are landless.
Because we do not have a say, our men are taking advantage of us. We have no say to our land. They go and talk to the boys and they agree and sell the piece of land. And we are all in trouble, because at the end of the day, we all suffer.
And it's not only human and the Maasai that are being affected by sale of land, even wildlife and livestock, because they all need that space for survival. We live south of Nairobi National Park, and it's one of the very critical, important area in terms of conservation, because it links Amboseli National Park, Maasai Mara, and Nairobi National Park. Since last year, we've been trying to think about how the university can help our village, and one of the areas that we are thinking is very important is food security. Because as a pastoral community, we depend on livestock. And because of climate change, when livestock move away from a family livelihood, then families are left with no option and no food. Climate change is real. And one of the things actually what we are doing now, thinking of doing planting crops and be able to empower women through bead selling, that's actually one of the mitigation measures we are looking at. If there will be like a long drought, we have been affected because we depend on livestock, and livestock have to time to move or die. I remember back in the year 2000, we lost up to 90% of our livestock. Yes, I remember in my family, we were only left with two cows. So we, from there, that's then we started picking up. Land is owned communally in our community. So we don't restrict people from moving from one area to another, because we have a proverb that says in our Maasai that the skin of a goat, of your goat, will never be enough to cover your body when it rains or during the cold. So because the skin of your sheep is not enough for you, you need the skin of my sheep so that you can be able to cover all your body. Same to a land, it's never enough. Your land will never be enough for your cow. So we have to own land communally so that it will be enough for all of us.
So if you help today, educate, take one girl to school, you will have helped the world Maasai community.